Okay, so today's session is exclusively for mental ability. Okay, should I begin? All of you set, ready? Okay, just put a thumbs up. Learn to use the reactions at the bottom. Put a thumbs up. Okay, so I'm beginning with... So, all of you can hear me fine. I'm beginning. Mental ability questions. If you want to, you know, you have to try and get good marks in this mental ability. So, mental ability questions is something you have to understand the techniques of solving mental ability questions. If you do not know the technique, you will just use trial and error method. So every question that is asked in mental ability has a technique of solving those mental ability questions. Second, one is, so you have to understand the technique. Second thing is, you have to practice as many as possible. And mental ability is something, you go on the internet and you will find many questions related to mental ability. Take up one type of questions and try solving them. Just like that only. Okay. And third technique is, in case you are not getting any technique to solve a question, try using the elimination method, as there is no negative marking for the mental ability questions. Okay. So three things you have to remember to practice mental ability. First is understand the technique. Second, practice using the technique, those type of questions. And third, in case nothing works for a particular, some question, nothing may work. So you have to use the elimination method. Try, you know, you will have to go by trial and error then. But otherwise, mental ability questions have to be tackled not using trial and error method, but using a specific technique. Any questions? Okay, so mental ability 40 marks. Try and get as many as you can. General knowledge can be a little, you know, out of this. Teacher aptitude, you can try get more marks. Mental ability, you can get more marks. General knowledge, okay, at least you get 10-15 marks also is fine. But try to get maximum marks in mental ability and teacher aptitude. Okay, I think some of you have attended the earlier part. I have done this. What type of questions are asked in mental ability? Okay, and what do those questions check? So these questions check how fast you can think, how quickly your mind works, and that you can do with practice and using technique. How accurately you can think, again technique comes in and practice comes in. How can you reason, technique again. And how alert you are, of course, technique and practice again. Of course, certain degree of practice and techniques are required. And some of you may be used to solving such mental ability questions even from your school days. Some of you may not be used to. So, doesn't matter, but you can practice right now and understand the technique of solving this type of questions. Now, what type of questions are asked in mental ability? The first type of questions asked is series questions. Please mute your mics. Please don't keep your mics unmuted. Please mute your mics. Series questions. Series is of two types. Alphabet series, numerical series. Then the classification type of questions, analogy and coding, decoding. Relationship, direction sense, blood relation, clock and calendar, and the puzzle test. So you have to understand that mental ability has to be dealt with by dividing the question. So you have to understand the technique of dealing with each type of question. Okay, so we start. Okay, the first one is the series, the number series. Look at the first series. The first one, I think we have done this question earlier also. Whenever you look at the number series, please have a paper pencil in your hand, a pen or paper in your hand. Look at the first number series. What do you observe? 4, 9, 16, 25. What do you observe here? Do you see, you have to see some pattern?
Squares. Squares of numbers.
Yeah, they are the squares of numbers. They could be prime numbers, they could be odd numbers, they could be even numbers. So you have to look at the series. So immediately when first thing you look at the numbers and it strikes you, okay, these are the squares of numbers. They could be cubes of numbers. So you should be familiar with at least squares of numbers from 2 to 10 or let's say 2 to 15 squares and even cubes of numbers. It could be cubes of numbers also. So as soon as you look at the series, it strikes you that these are the squares of numbers or they could be prime numbers, anything. So these are the squares of numbers. So what is the answer? 4 square of 2, 9 square of 3, 16 square of 4, 25 square of
36.
The next is square of 6 is 36. Now look at the next question. Complete the series. Now what do you observe? Do you see, are there the prime numbers or you all know what are prime numbers? Numbers. You all know what are prime numbers? Numbers which are divisible.
That can be divided by themselves and one only.
Yes, very good, very good. So those are prime numbers are numbers which can be divided by themselves only. So you cannot, they are not multiples of any numbers. They are just divisible by themselves. So those are prime numbers. So these are not prime numbers, not odd numbers, not squares, not cubes. Then what do you do? So immediately you have to see, is a number being added or subtracted from the preceding number? What is the preceding number? 13 is the first number, 24 second number. So are you supposed to add quickly on your paper 13 and 24? What difference do you get? 24 minus 13, what is the answer?
11.
Okay. 46 minus 24. So above the numbers 22. Only just write. Yeah, it was 11, 22. 22. And then 46 and
22.
No, 46 minus 24 is 22. 90 minus 46?
44.
Yeah, so what is happening? 11 became 22, 22 became 44. Now what would happen to 44 next?
88.
It becomes 88. So 178 minus 90 is 88.
88.
Yes. So do you see that every number, like 11 multiplied by 2 gives you 22. 22 multiplied by 2 gives you 44. 44 multiplied by 2, 88. 88 multiplied by 2?
176.
354.
176 you add to 178. So the answer is 354. What the technique of series? Either look at the number. Are they square? Square roots? Cubes? Prime numbers, odd numbers. You know what are odd numbers and even numbers? You all know what is odd numbers and...
Yes, ma'am. Divisible by two.
Divisible by two are
yes, ma'am.
Okay, even numbers. Yeah. So see, we have used technique for solving. And once you know the technique, you can be 100% sure that your answer would be correct. Okay? A few questions here and there, you have to use trial and error method, but many of the questions are using techniques. Okay? So, how do we solve this questions based on series numbers, number series. Look out for the pattern. Are they consecutive odd numbers, even numbers, prime numbers, squares and cubes of numbers? Or is there some sum? Is something being added to the preceding number to get the next number? Like we just saw the case. Is it the product of two numbers? Are we multiplying something with the preceding number to get the next number? Or are we subtracting and getting something? Or is some number being added, subtracted, multiplied, divided by some number? So you have to check out this when you're doing a number series. So next time, whenever you see a number series, use this technique. The first 2 points you check out. If that does not work, you have to check out for the third and the fourth point. So after this session or tomorrow onwards, please practice. So anytime you see a number series type question, start applying the rule, the technique. Okay? And then see, you'll be able to solve the sums, the questions. Okay? Now the second type of questions are alphabet series. Okay? So I move ahead. It is called as solve two more questions I've kept for you. This is also something interesting. Please solve the third one. What do you observe? Now this time in the third question, don't start from left. Start from right. Start from right.
Ma'am, they're the deciding number of multiple. Like two, if you go from right, it becomes 2 5s are 10. Then it 10 4s are 40. Then 40 into 3 is 120, and 120 into 2 is?
What?
It's not working.
It's working. It is 240 only.
Okay.
That's the end. Just 240. Just leave it there. One minute. I'm sorry. There's a slight mistake in that. The 240, the answer only, I have kept it there. There's a slight mistake. The answer is 240. Okay, there is nothing in that 240 is nothing there, but by mistake that 240 has come up there. So 2 multiplied by 5 gives you 10. 10 multiplied by 4 gives you 40. 40 multiplied by 3 gives you 120. It's correct. It's correct. 120 multiplied by 2 gives you 240. And 240 multiplied by 1 gives you 240. I'm sorry, that is correct. The 240 would appear there. It is coming. Are you all getting it? The answer is 240. But as the series, you have 2 multiplied by 5 gives you 10. 10 multiplied by 4 gives you 40. 40 multiplied by 3 gives you 120. 120 multiplied by 2 gives you 240. And 240 multiplied by 1 gives you 240. Fine? Has everyone got it? Has everyone got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Look at the fourth question. Now you start from left again. 1 and 2, 2 and 7, 7. What is it? Something descending and something ascending again. Some pattern is there. Please check out.
Ma'am, is the answer 19?
Yes, the answer is 19. How did you get it?
Ma'am, alternate numbers from the top, they are increased by 6.
No, go this way. 1 and 2, the difference is 1. 1 plus 1 gives 2. 2 plus 5 gives 7. So 1, 5, 0. 7 and 7 difference is 0. So 1, 5, 0. Again, it goes 5 minus 5, sorry, plus 5 minus 1. It goes that way.
Okay.
So there is that pattern, again a pattern, and that pattern continues again. So 13 and 12, the difference is 1. Again, add 12 to, 5 to 12. Sorry, 1 minute. You're adding? Yeah, you're adding? What is it?
No, ma'am.
Just check out.
Ma'am, the first and the third number, if you add 6, then the third and the fifth number, you add 6 to it. And the similarly, the second and the fourth, you add 5. Then the fourth and the sixth, you add 5. So it's 6, 5, 6, 5. I mean, that's what I did. I don't know.
Okay, you got a pattern, but
yeah, one,
you're observing a pattern.
Yeah, I did.
See, you can try.
That's what I did.
Multiple ways of doing it, but then you are observing a pattern. Are you observing a pattern?
Yes, ma'am. The first and the third, and third and the fifth, and fifth and the seventh, because the blank is the seventh number.
Okay.
The blank is the seventh space.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did was...
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
You got the pattern. So 1 and 7, there is a difference of 6. 7 and 13, there is a difference of 6. 13 and 19, there is a difference of 6. That is also fine.
Okay. Thank you.
So ultimately, the answer is 19.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'll move ahead. Okay. Now we come to the alphabet series. Look at the alphabet series. Y, U, Q, M, I. Just quickly write down all the alphabets and check which position is occupied by these alphabets given. Is there any difference of certain numbers between the alphabets? Check out that and tell me what is the answer.
Ma'am, there is a pattern. 3 alphabets are skipped between each of the alphabets.
Okay.
Given.
So why?
Y, then X, W, and V are skipped.
Okay.
Then comes U.
Okay.
Then again, 3 alphabets are skipped. So T, S, R are skipped. Q comes in.
Okay.
So, after I, that's why when we skip 3 alphabets, we get H, G, F gets skipped and E becomes the answer.
Perfectly. Has everyone got it? So, even in alphabets, you're supposed to see some pattern. Some alphabets are skipped, but there is a pattern. 3 alphabets are skipped and you get the next earlier alphabet. And it does not follow normal A to Z pattern. It follows a Z to A pattern. Now look at the 6th alphabet series. One request. In case you are finding it a little fast, doesn't matter. And if your question remains, just make a note of your question. At the end, if you have not understood the technique, we will look at it again. Okay? So don't wait. If you are not able to solve, please move ahead. Okay, what is the completed series? What pattern?
The answer is V.
Yes, answer is V. How did you get the answer?
As like B for B it is Y, C for it is X, and D for W, and E for U. It is decreasing from like Z, Y, X, W, V.
Okay. Or I will look at it this way. That if I take B, the second alphabet from the beginning, I take Y, the second alphabet from the end, and I put it together. If I take C, the third alphabet from the beginning, I have to take the third alphabet at the end and put it together. Okay, fine. D, W, similarly E comes. So E is the fifth alphabet from the beginning. So from the end, which is the fifth alphabet? So that is V.
V.
Okay?
Yes.
Fine. So some more. So what do you do in alphabets? Again, you look out for patterns. Either it is single alphabet. Okay, it's a series of single alphabet as you saw. It could be a pair of alphabets. A, B, A, X. Something would have been like B, Y. C, X. Even that group of numbers or combination of letters or numbers could be given. So any of this, again, you will have to look out for a pattern. And when you look out for the pattern, you will find the difference of some numbers between the letters. Okay, some more questions on alphabet. Please look at this. Look at the 7th question. how many numbers are left. Give a every alphabet, give a number. Like B is 2, C is 3, D is 4, E is 5. Look at it that way and see what is the answer.
Ma'am, is it P?
Yes, you're right. How did you get it? Explain the, give me the explanation.
Ma'am, the difference between B and D is one. Okay. One alphabet.
Okay.
But the difference between D and G, there are two alphabet difference.
Okay.
And then G to K, we have three alphabet difference. So okay, accordingly, it goes into an increasing order of alphabets. Like okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
So K, 4. K plus 4 gives you P. Fine?
Yes.
Yeah, I think don't bother to look at V. Just finish off your series. So P till P, it's fine. Done? Okay, look at the 8th question now. I think the order, the technique was very clear. Look at the order. A little different question I've taken. Arrange the following in the order of dictionary. Again, in dictionary, it follows certain alphabet order. So I've kept it. Please check quickly and tell me what is the order.
Scandal, scenery, school, science.
Okay. Scandal.
Scenery. School science.
So, I think the B one is the answer, but there is some error in that writing. What you are saying is correct. It should be 3, scandal first, second, scenery. 3-1.
Yeah, 3-1.
And then comes your 4 and 2. Isn't it? Yeah, it's right. B1 yes. is the right answer. No, it's yeah. the right
correct,
answer.
Ma'am. It's correct.
It's correct, yeah. It's correct. Fine, got it? It's very easy. Scandal S. Oh, everybody, all the words start with the letter S. Look at the second letter C. So you don't have to bother. Then look at the third letter. So third letter, scandal is the only word which starts with A. So that would begin with A. Scandal is the first word. Then the second word A, then comes scenery E, third letter. Then comes school H, okay? And then comes I. So accordingly, scandal, scenery, school, science. That is the way we look at letter, the way alphabetically words are organized in a dictionary. Okay?
Ma'am, can you repeat this once again?
Yeah. See, how do you look at these words? These are words in the dictionary. The way words are organized in the dictionary, it is based in an alphabetical order. Now look at the four words. What is common? First and the second, S and C is common. So you don't have to bother about the first. Yeah.
Yeah.
So which letter do you start looking at is the third letter now.
Third
letter. What is the third letter? Third letter is different in all the cases. Yeah. The third letter is scenery E, science I, and scandal A, and school H. Now, what is the alphabetical order? What should come first?
Okay. Third A one, scandal.
A comes first, scandal. Second first. Comes your
E.
Scenery E.
Scenery. That is scenery.
Third comes your school H, and then comes I. After H comes I.
Okay,
so
okay.
Science comes fourth.
Oh, okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Look at the 9th question.
Ma'am, is the answer
P? P is the answer.
P is the answer.
Yeah, but how did you get it?
The difference.
Even numbers.
What are you
ma'am,
getting?
The difference between A and D is 2. Two letters are missing in that. And in the case of D and I, and in the case of D and I, there are 4 letters missing.
Okay.
So accordingly, the number difference are 2, 4, 8.
Eight.
So after I, there should be 8 number in between there. So the next number should be?
Ninth number. Isn't it? Ninth number is the number P.
That's what I did.
Yeah, you're right.
2, 4, 6.
Ma'am, the sequence is 2, 4, 6.
Even
numbers.
2, 4, 6. 1 minute. 2, 4,
because
six,
the option.
Six.
Yeah, because the option
six,
is not given.
6, yeah. 6, here. Yeah.
6, yeah.
If the option was given as S, then it could have been that way.
8, 9, 1. You're right. Option is P. So it is the 6th number. 2, 4, 6.
6.
Fine. P is the answer. But you're leaving two alphabets like A and D, B and C is left out. Two are left out and you have to consider the third one. After D, you're leaving out four alphabets and you're looking at the fifth alphabet. After I, you're leaving out six alphabets and you're looking at the seventh alphabet. So you have to be alert about that also. Okay? So I stop with alphabet series. At times, rare occasions, you may have something like alphanumeric series also. Alphanumeric is numbers and letters both mixture. But you will have to follow the same pattern. The same technique has to be used. Rare occasions I have seen alphanumeric series is also observed. Okay. Next is classification. You all know classification. You all classify. In the library, how are books classified? Based on some order. Even if you go to any big, DMart and all, everything, soap section is different. Oil section is different. Similarly, that is based on classification. So all the toiletries you will find together, grains you will be put together. So similarly, you'll have metals put together, non-metals put together, alloys put together. Now look at the 10th one and see what you observe.
Brass is the answer.
Yeah. I think you should be clear that there are elements. Elements are pure substances. Oxygen, nitrogen, fluorine, copper, iron, aluminium are pure substances found in their pure state. So they are called as elements. Whereas compounds are water, carbon dioxide are compounds. And whenever you mix two metals together, you get an alloy. Brass. I think please mute yourself. Okay, so the answer is brass. Why is the answer brass?
Brass is an alloy.
Okay, and alloy.
The others are metals.
Yeah, others are metals. So what is the group? The group copper, iron, aluminium is of metals. Only brass. So if you group them, what is the common characteristic on the basis of which you're grouping them? On the basis of whether they are metals or they are something else. So you have grouped them as metals. Now, brass is something different. It is a mixture of two metals. Hence, that is a odd man out. So, whenever you are solving a sum on classification, look out for common idea, common characteristic. Now, here the common characteristic is metals. And whatever is the odd one out there, you have to pick it out. That is your, choose the option which is least like others in the group. So, brass is out. Look at the 11th one.
Ma'am, is the answer is textbook?
Textbook. Yeah. Pen, paper, sharpener are stationery and textbook is not a stationery. Because textbook is a part of your school, the actual, part of your curriculum syllabus. But paper, pencil, sharpener could be anything. It's a stationery. So textbook is the odd person out there. Next. So how do you classify things? First of all, put the items. Look at the items. And put the items in the group on the basis of certain common quality. Once you try to, you get the common quality. Haan, ye metals hai. These are stationary items. You will find one thing is a stranger or the odd man out. So please remove that. Just a minute. Yeah. So you'll have to pull that out. That is the idea here. Now let us solve some questions on classification. Look at this one. 12th one.
Ma'am, is the answer
25-35 is the answer. How did you get the answer? What common idea did you use for putting the A, C, D together?
Because the first one A, it's 9 is 3, 3 is a 9, 6 is a 36, so it's 3 and 6.
Yeah, then square C of 3 is, and 6.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then look then at the C1.
It's 4, 4 is a 16 and 8, 8 is a 64.
Okay. And D1?
Then the D1, 49, 7, 7,
7, 7, 7.
Okay.
49 and
so there is a commonality in all of them. They are the squares of numbers, okay, and squares of almost the same number, like 3 or multiple of that. Whereas 25 and 35 something out. 25 is a square, but 35 is not a square of any number. So it is the odd one out. So 25, 35 is the answer. Look at the 13th one. What commonality? Textbook and R is the answer. What commonality did you get between A, C,
and is measured in kilogram.
Measurement.
Yeah. Measurement.
Yeah, uh-huh. The object. See, you have to look at it. The object and its measurement. Pencil is measured. Length is measured with meter scale. Milk is measured using liter. Wheat is measured using kilogram. Textbook, R, what is the relationship? Textbook could be weighed as you give in raddi or you buy books, you put it in form of mass, or maybe you measure its length for putting a cover. But textbook and R has no relation. Okay, so it is the odd one out. Got the idea? Hope everyone has understood. How do you look at classification questions? Okay, now next we move to analogies. Look at this analogies. Museum is to curator as
curator one custom doctor jail jailer lawyer court warden hospital hostel doctor
museum to curator lawyer jail to jailer.
Yeah, jail to jailer. What is the logic? What commonality are you using to group A, C, D, and removing B out? What commonality did you use?
In museum curator.
Museum curator is the person who looks after the museum.
Place.
Or who works there. Looks after or works there? Works there. So similarly, hostel is a place. Hostel to doctor, hospital to doctor is the right answer.
Yeah, this is
but the this is not content. The right answer. So it is a mismatch. Hostel, doctor, this is a mismatch. And which is the right, this, it's jail to jailer. The analogy, this is not
jail to jailer.
Jail to jailer. So what is going with museum and curator? Museum is a place, jail is a place. Curator is a person who works in the museum or takes care of the museum. Jailer is a person who works in the jail or takes care of the jail. Warden hospital, no relation. Lawyer court, it could have been correct only if it would have
been first.
Court and lawyer. Look at the 15th question.
Horse.
Okay. What relation did you, what analogy did you see? Did you see a relation between the two? Analogy. Paw is to cat. Paw. Cat has
yes,
a paw.
Yes, ma'am, because that's the feet. Yeah.
Hoof of a elephant, horse, lion, lamb.
Elephant, horse.
Horse. Horse has a hoof. It's in horse hooves.
Yeah.
Okay, so the answer is horse. Look at the 16th one.
The answer is bacteria.
Bacteria.
Yeah, now in this analogy, some of you may be very particular about words, or you may be good at words, you may be good at science related ideas, you may be good at other things. So somewhere you'll take time, but you will be able to do it. Influenza is caused by virus. Typhoid is caused by bacteria. Parasite is the malarial parasite. Mosquito has a parasite called as plasmodium, or you can call it, it's a protozoa also. It's a protozoa. Parasite could be amoeba as a parasite, or it could be a protozoa also. Fungal infections are caused by the fungus. Mucor is a fungus, or you get fungus on the plants and all. Typhoid is clearly caused by a bacteria. Okay, now look at the analogies. What analogies should you be familiar with? You should know countries and their capitals.
Country, capital.
You can just type on Google it, country and capitals you should be aware of. Country and currency. Which country has which type of currency? Is it the sum, product, difference or numbers? You have to look out for that. Is it animal and the young one? Analogy is animal and its young one. Hen, chick or chicken. Sorry, it would be a hen, chick. Or animal and the sound it makes. Or animal and the movement. So you have to look at the relationship. So how do you look at the relation between the two words on the basis of, is it animal and its young ones, animal and the sound, animal and the movement, or is it thing and the class? Thing and the class is like, if you see, you know, this could be related more to science. Mango tree is a tree. Mango is a tree. Whereas tulsi is a shrub. Okay? So something like that. Things and class. Or cactus comes under xerophytes. Okay? Or human beings come under the class mammals. Rat comes under the class mammals. That way. Workers and the products. Okay, the cobbler, shoes. Fine? Workers and the working place. Doctor, hospital. Court, lawyer, court. Words and their synonyms could be an analogy. Games and the place. Tennis is played in a tennis court. Cricket is played in a proper field. Product and the material that is used. Suppose I have a shelf. Shelf, wood. Okay? Railway tracks, metal. So based on this, you have to look out for. So whenever you have questions based on analogy, you have to look out for the relationship. What is it? What is it trying to convey? Based on that, you have to give your answer. Look at this. 17 question. Skin psoriasis as
C.
Which is the one?
C.
A.
You're right. C is the correct answer.
C. C.
C. I. Skin is the organ. Psoriasis. And psoriasis is the disease. Eye is the organ, cataract is the disease. Teeth and rhinitis don't go together. Nose and cavity does not go. Blood and COVID, no. Okay? Look at the 18th question.
Leather.
Leather.
Yes, leather.
Leather, leather. Leather.
What relation leather. Did you see? What relation?
Plane is made of aluminium and shoe is made up of leather.
Perfectly all right. Okay? Fine. Analogy part is clear. What you should know with respect to analogies, I have given you a list. You should be familiar with all that. Next, we come to coding and decoding. Look at this question. I have given this earlier, this also. See, how do you code this? What could be the answer? Write sugar and below sugar, write Z, N, M, D, B. So S stands for Z, U stands for N, G stands for M, A stands for D, R stands for B. Again, in the same manner, write T and below T, write FLD. Now, based on that, tell me how do you code great.
Fourth one.
Ma'am, the answer is fourth one.
Which one?
Fourth one.
1 minute. Huh? What does G stand for?
G stands for M.
M. What does R stand for?
B.
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 And what does A stand for?
D.
D. D.
Fine, you got it? Only thing, when yes. You're coding, decoding. Like if you remember when we were small, we used to play a game. We used to code our letters, ch language and all that, and put it across to somebody so that the other person, only our friend understands our language. Okay? So similarly here, either sugar could be coded as some letters or it could be coded as some numbers. So you have to see what is it coded. So that is the correct answer. Now go to 20th one. Again, write farmer. Below farmer, write 562042. hot and right below hot 817. And tell me how his mother put it there.
017842.
Option B. B option.
The answer is option B.
B and D are same only.
Achha, okay.
There yeah.
Similarity has come. There's an error. Okay. So 017842. You don't bother about 8. Just tell me what is the answer. 017842. Because I have prepared. I have typed all this in the PPT. Somewhere something must have gone wrong. So how did you get it? M. What is the number for M?
Zero.
O.
Zero.
O.
One.
One.
Okay. You have organized everything properly and based on that you are yes. getting this answer. Fine.
Yes.
Okay. Now what do you do in coding and decoding? In coding and decoding, we try to, sometimes we have to find out the common letters in the words. At times there is an easy technique. Of course the two questions were easy, but at times there could be a little difficult question also. At that time you have to see which two letters, which are the common letters in the words and which number comes commonly for those common letters and try to find the code for the common letters. For example, I'll show you one. Now the 22nd is based on what I was just sharing. Look at the 21st one. Read it carefully, yeah, and then answer. 21st.
Ma'am, is it wall?
Yeah, it is wall. Some of you may get confused because you may feel, achha, bed is called wall, wall is called terrace. No, don't go ahead that way. Here, nobody is, it is the object. Object window is called floor. That's it. So, window is the object and it is coded as floor. Floor is the object and it is called as door. It is coded as door. Okay, ceiling is the object and for ceiling we are using the word bed. And bed is the object, it is called as coded as wall. Okay, so once it is coded as wall, it is over. And wall is the object which is coded as terrace. So here the coding is very clear. Where do I sleep in? I sleep in a bed. And what is bed coded as? Wall. So wall is the answer. Now look at the 22nd one and see which common words. Which are the common words there in 22nd one? And what are the codes used for it? You can write it down. 7 apples. 4 R. Try doing it that way also.
Ma'am, in the first and second sentence, apples are good. So, apple...
I think 9.
4. Yeah, and is yeah. 9. Yeah.
Ma'am, is it 9?
How did you get
9? Yeah.
Tell me the logic. Answer the things. How did you get
it? Ma'am,
yeah.
We have to see the common numbers.
Yeah.
Common and allot them the letters.
Common letters. Apples, good. Good is there in apples are good and buy good fruits. Good is there in both the places. So what is the letter for good? Now tell me.
7.
Okay, then look at apples are red. Apples are red and apples are good. What is the common letter there? Apples are. 3, 4 and 4, 3.
So 3, 4. Yeah.
So somewhere it is 3, somewhere it is 4. Okay. And what is the letter for R then? Red then 9.
9.
Okay. So you have to use logic. You have to find which two words are common. Find the code for it. And then accordingly identify what it would be for red.
Ma'am, can you explain this one again?
Yeah. See, look at the first, 743 means apples are good. Fine. Now we don't know. They have not used the technique. 7 means apple, nothing like that. Okay, that technique is not used here. So whenever you have such type of questions, 743 means apples are good. But in that, 7 does not mean apples. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Like what we have seen in the earlier technique, 7 does not mean apples. How do we understand that? 6, 5, 7. 7 is getting repeated and it says buy good fruits. So what is common between apples are good and buy good fruits? Which word is common?
Good.
Good. And what is a common code which is getting repeated in both 743 and 657? Which code, which number is getting repeated?
Seven.
So for good, what stands for good? Seven. Okay, now look at the third one. 934 means apples are red. Now apples are in this sentence and apples are good. Common hai, apples are. Now which one is common over there in both the places? See, common words, common numbers, common codes. Apples are. And in 743 and 934, 43 and 34, the two numbers are getting repeated. So what is different in apples are red? What is different? What stands for red? Red, 9 stands for
nine.
So you have to use that logic. At times, this is a little higher difficulty level. So when such a question comes, you have to see, you have to put all three sentences, look at two at a time and see what is common, what are the common words in two sentences and what is the common code that is used, common number that is used. Then take second and the third sentence, see what is the common letter and check out. And in this manner, you will get which is the unique number for red or any other word. Fine?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, now there's something interesting. Blood relations. This too I had done earlier also. Please look at this. Try solving the 23rd one.
Sister.
What is the answer?
Sister.
Sister. Yeah, right. Yeah. How did you get the logic? What was the technique used by you? What technique did you use? The lady? She says her grandfather, that is her one generation, the second, before that generation. Okay. Then my grandfather's only sons. That means her grandfather's only son. Grandfather had only one son. And that son has a daughter. And that daughter is the sister to this lady. Okay. I'll show you, there's a special technique. I'll talk about it after this question. Look at the 24th question.
Uncle.
Yeah, uncle is the right answer. That means you have some technique of solving this. Some of you may be thinking that thoda difficult lag raha hai. There is too much of information and how do we organize that information? It is very easy. You just have to organize the information and understand the relations. Okay? Can I move ahead and talk about the technique? Can I talk about the technique?
Yeah.
Okay. Let us understand the blood relations. So you have to be clear about the blood relations. Mother's or father's son, like my mother's or father's son is my brother. My mother's or father's daughter is my sister. And if that my father's or mother's only daughter is me only. But it is not saying only daughter. It is saying daughter. So it could be my other sister, my sister. If it says only daughter, then it is me. Mother's father's brother is an uncle. Mother's father's sister is an aunt. Mother's or father's father is a grandfather. Mother's father's mother is a grandmother. I have written grandmother, typing error. Son's wife, if your own son's wife is called as daughter-in-law. Your daughter's husband is your son-in-law. your husband's or wife's sister is your sister-in-law. Your husband or wife's brother is your brother-in-law. Your brother's son is your nephew. Your brother's daughter is your niece. Okay, it could be brother or even sister's daughter is called as niece. Uncle or aunt's son or daughter is a cousin. Sister's husband is a brother-in-law. Brother's wife is a sister-in-law. Okay, fine. Are you clear with the relations? Okay. Now, how do we, you know, assemble the entire information that is given to us? Because in just 1 minute, we have to solve one question of mental ability. So how do we quickly organize? What technique to use? The technique is simple. As soon as you start looking, reading the information, sentence by sentence, start organizing the information. Relations, we just saw. How do we organize the information? Use some symbols or codes for that. Look at the codes. Suppose you feel that A is a male. Okay, it's written there. A is a boy. So what have I put for a boy? I write A on the paper. And what do I put up around A? What is put around A?
Rectangle.
Yeah, it's a small
rectangle.
It's a square. Put a square or a rectangle. Put a square. Okay, or a rectangle, whatever you want, to indicate that A is a boy, a male, not a boy, male. For a female, A is a female. So what have I used?
A and a circle.
Yeah. Clear? So when you're writing, you know, you're putting this information on piece of paper, you're organizing it to see the relation. Whenever you're writing, you know that it's a male, put a box, square around A. And if you feel that it's a female, put a circle. And if you find that I don't know what is the sex of that person, it's not given. So do not put anything. Whenever you find that A and B are married, A is B's wife or B is A's husband, how will you, what symbol will you use? A is equal to B. Okay? And if you find that A and B are siblings, brothers and sisters, or brother brothers and sisters, then what do you put? You put a two-sided arrow between A and B. Are you getting the symbols that I'm using?
Yes, ma'am.
A and C are B's children. So what do? You write B above, and C and D are children. So put a arrow, put a line below B. Okay, and right there, C and D. Put a line. You can draw, you know, that my symbol has not come again perfect. But you can draw a line and put small, you know, like arrows below that.
Ma'am, A and C, na? C and D, how come? A and C are B's children.
Some typing error. A and C are okay. B's children. Look at the symbol. Okay. Only child, uncle, aunt. Only child. When you have only child, as soon as you see only child, how will you write it? Suppose C is the only child of B. So you'll write B on the top and C, put a downward arrow and write C below that to indicate that C is the only child of B. Okay? Similarly, suppose C is the only child of A. And A and B are siblings, or B is the brother of A. So look at the symbols I have used. A and B, double-sided arrow indicates that they are siblings. And one arrow downward indicates that C is the only child of A. Remember the symbols. Note down so that when we are solving the next questions, you can use it. Fine? Some more are there. No, that's it. Fine? Clear with the symbols? Suppose you know that A and B are husband and wife. B is A's wife. So how will you organize it? B is A's wife. what will you write? You'll write A. What will you put around A?
Equal to.
Huh, you'll put equal to sign, but what will you put around A to show that A is a
square?
Matter? Square. And a what square. Will you put around B?
A circle.
Circle. Use your own symbols if you want. If you don't want to use what I have given. Okay. So now, whenever you're doing any blood relations, you have to draw a family tree. I said that you organize the information in the sense that prepare a family tree. How do you prepare the family tree? Read one sentence at a time. Identify the male, female. Put each member in their respective position in the tree. Children, brother, married, grandfather. So how do you go about? So put it in the proper respective position. Which generation? Grandfather's sister. So you'll put in that generation when you're drawing your family tree. Put the symbols as indicated earlier, the box, the circle, the downward arrow, and you will get to see the relation. Now use the symbols and this relations to answer the next questions.
Is the answer C?
It's mother. You've gone wrong somewhere. Your father's only daughter. Now, your father has only one daughter. Your father's only daughter is who? It's you.
Ma'am, is the answer C?
Yes, ma'am, it's mother.
Yeah, ma'am, mother.
Pointing to a man. Now look at this, huh? Pointing to a man. The man, there is somebody, okay? Someone, a person is somebody, a person pointing to a man and talking to a woman, okay? And what is he telling the woman? The man standing there is your father's. Whose father? The woman's father or the man's father?
Woman's father.
Yeah,
woman's father. Mother,
father's only daughter's only daughters. Your father's only daughter. Your father has only one daughter. So you are taking it as sister. How can it be only daughter? Only one daughter. Your father has only one daughter. So how can you have a sister? Try to get this.
Yeah, mother.
Mother. The answer is mother. How is the lady related to mother? How is the man related to the lady? Then it would be the son. But if it is lady related to man, is the mother. Try the 26th one also.
Ma'am, is it father-in-law?
Yeah.
Father-in-law.
Did you draw the family chart? Try drawing the family
father-in-law.
Chart. Yes. Yes, ma'am.
All of you draw the family chart using all the symbols and all. Family tree. Done. Draw the family tree.
Father-in-law.
Father-in-law. In the 25th question, besides the family tree, there is somebody pointing at a man, a woman. So taking into consideration that part also.
Father-in-law.
Okay. You'll get many more questions on the net. Just type blood questions based on MCQs based on blood relation. and you'll find many questions of this type. That time, use the proper symbols to get the correct answer. Okay? Shall I move ahead? Should I? Should I?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, this we had done once earlier also. I've kept some of the questions because you were, some of you are new and were asking me for the mental ability. So, there are some of the questions. Now, when you're doing this, sitting around, so as far as possible, draw a circle. Okay? And write A, B, or organize all those people around it.
Taylor and Cook.
Yeah, the answer is Taylor and Cook. There are four people. Look at their occupations.
Taylor and Cook.
Yeah. Based on the occupations, there won't be any overlapping. Naturally, there won't be any overlapping of occupations. So if you get everything proper, you'll get the answer Taylor and Cook. Because C is sitting opposite to B.
Miss, can you please explain this?
Yeah. First of all, have you drawn a drawing? Draw a circle. There are four people, A, B, C, D. Don't draw them right now. Look at some of the information given. And see that you'll find that D sits opposite to B. So draw D on one side and opposite to D, draw C. Okay. Now, who are the two people left? A and B are left. Now, how to put A and B? Okay, where do you put A and B? That is the confusion. Now, start looking at the information. Mr. A sits opposite to Cook. Put your A somewhere. Write A between C and D. Any place, write A. And on the opposite side, write Cook. Fine? Then Miss B sits right to the barber. You've already got the... B is sitting right to the barber. Right of the barber. So who's the person sitting right to the barber? Is B.
Yes.
Okay. See, when you see the right and the left, assume that you are sitting in that place and your right and your left. If you try to draw and see as other person's left and right, you'll get confused. So whenever you're doing such questions, assume that if I am Mr. B and B sits right to the barber. So barber would be on my left side. Okay. Right of the barber means my left. So accordingly, if you go on organizing the information, you will get the correct answer.
Thank you, ma'am.
Try it out. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, how do we do a puzzle test? In a puzzle test, do not read the entire information in one go. go step by step. Read one step, draw it, symbolize it, use symbols for persons, items. Suppose it is an object, so put a dot. If it is a person, you can use letters or something. If there are items, put a dot. Lines, if you want to put across, you know, opposite and all, you can put lines. Okay? Like table was there. So you can put a dot as a table and put people around it. If sitting in a circle, draw a circle. Square, draw a square. And if it is too much of complicated information, it can be summarized in the form of a table. Now let us see how. Okay? Now look at this question. Don't look at my table. Just read the question carefully. There are six books. A, B, C, D, E, F. B, C, E, F have green covers, while others have yellow covers. A, D, B are new books, while others are old. A, C, B are science books, while others are education books. Which two books are old education books and have green covers? For such type of information, please draw a table. Okay, look at the table I have drawn. And if you look at the table, you will quickly get the answer. You just have to put a tick mark in your boxes. See, like B, C, E, F have green covers. So B, C, E, F, put tick mark. And others have yellow colors, covers. So put a tick mark. Like that, you organize your information and you will get the correct answer. Yes. So, education books, so it could be DEF, old hai, so it would be EF, and they have green covers, means it is pakka E and F. So, the answer is E and F. All of you got the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so when you have such a complicated information, put it in the form of a box to get the answer. So the correct answer is E and F. Two books are, they are education books, they are old and have green covers. So the answer is E and F, where you put, I have put a different symbol, you can put a tick mark there. Fine, one more question on puzzle test. Look at this one. Don't put it in a circle. It is nowhere written it's a circle. 29 question. Just write A, B, C, D, E. And put it in a table. Put this in a table and put tick marks. A, B, C, D, E, you put out on the left hand side and on the top you put headings intelligent, hardworking, honest, ambitious and put tick marks. Read one step at a time and put tick marks.
Ma'am, C.
C is the right answer. Did you prepare the table?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Others, are you working on it?
Yes.
C is the correct answer.
C is the correct answer.
C.
Next one.
B.
B.
Yeah. Yes.
B, B.
Which one? B or D?
Bombay.
B, B.
B. All of you, please check whether you're getting the right answer.
Yes, ma'am, it's B.
Perfect. There is no chance of going wrong, no?
No.
Look at this one, 30th one. Now don't draw a table for the 30th and 31st one. Huh? This is not a table wala problem. It's a simple. V, W, X, Y, Z are sitting in a row, a line. And they are facing you. You are on their opposite side. Read information carefully and draw. Be careful with the left and the right hand side.
Is it Y?
Yeah.
Y.
Yes, you're right. Others, are you getting it?
Yes, ma'am.
Y is on the left of X. I is on the, W is on the right of Z. Be very clear with left and right. Huh? If you are sitting on the opposite side, left and right is the opposite of, or you sit in that person's position. Assume that you are X and Y is on the left of X. So immediately you understand left is your left. Otherwise, what happens is, if something is happening on the opposite side and you're trying to see as a third person, it becomes difficult. So as you imagine that you are X and you are Z. So W is sitting on your right side. Then it becomes easier for you. Answer is Y. Done, everyone? And take information one step at a time. Do not just try to put in all the information. Take one at a time, draw it, and then read the next part of the information. Done? Go to the 31st one also.
Can you explain this question?
Which one? 30th one? 30th one?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Yeah. Do one thing. First of all, you draw V, W, X, Y, Z. Draw them, leaving some space in between them, okay? Leave some space between V, W, X, Y, Z and draw them. Write them. Write down the letters. Okay? They are all are sitting in a row. Okay? In such a manner that Y is on the left of X. Now see in your diagram, assume that you are X. So is Y sitting on your left side? Yeah? Y is on your left side? In your, you have drawn? Y is on the left side of X?
No. Why? No, ma'am, it's on right side.
No, that's the assumption you have to make. That's what you have to write.
See, try to understand.
Y is on the left of X.
Yeah, there are two techniques, okay? One is...
It's given. Yeah. It's given in the question.
Yeah. Assume that you are sitting on the opposite side and you are looking at them as if they are sitting in opposite to you. So, their left would be your right. That is one way. Ulta dekhna hai. Left is right for you. Okay, if I am saying like it is my right, so it would be your left if you are sitting opposite to me. Okay? Now, or the other technique is assume that you are X. Like I find it very difficult with this technique that I'm sitting opposite to someone and then my left and right, I get confused. So what I do is I assume that I am X. Assume you are X there. Okay, you are sitting there in the place of X. Okay, and then which is your left side? Which is your left hand? You'll take some time to understand this. Assume that you are sitting there in the place of X.
Okay.
Then Y is on the left of X. So what is drawn there is correct.
Yes.
V, W, X, Y, Z, barabar hai?
Order? Correct, okay. Yes.
Now W is on the right of Z. W is on the right of Z. Barabar hai? That is also fine.
Barabar hai.
Now V is on the right of X. V is on the right of X. Barabar hai information?
Right.
What you have? Nahin, barabar hai ki? You tell me.
Yes,
barabar
sir,
hai na?
Right.
V is on the right of X. And W is on the left of Y. Assume you are Y now. And W is on your left?
No, it's in right.
Yeah, so you have to remove W from there and put it between Y and Z. Got it?
Yes.
Then your information is correct. Then W is on the left of Y. And Z is occupies a corner position. Corner position barabar hai. Z is at the end. Last mein hai. Then who is sitting in the center? Y barabar aayega. V, X, Y, W, Z is the order. Okay, see how you manage, because left and right, okay. Even I find it confusing. So what I do is I always assume, my imagination is very good. So I imagine that I am sitting there in the place of X. I am sitting there as Z. I am sitting there as X. Okay, and then I see my right and left. Then it becomes easy for me. Look at the 31st one. Look at the 31st one. A little tricky, huh?
Ma'am, is the first subsection of 31 the answer is D.
Yeah, I think so. Let me also check. I don't have the answer in front of me. Let me also check. Huh? 1 minute. Give me a minute. Yes. D is, what did you say? D, no? Yeah.
And the second subsection is E.
F is not the first or the last two. Yeah, right. This is a little out of the box, a little tricky, a little tricky.
Miss, can you explain this again?
Basically, you cannot just organize them as it is, as the information, B, C, D, E, F, you cannot put them in a row. How do
okay.
you look at it is, the one who reads first gives it to
yeah.
D. So you do
yeah.
not know who read it first.
Yeah.
Okay, but D is the person who reads it second. Okay.
Second,
and,
yeah.
And the one who reads last has taken from B.
Yeah.
Okay. So naturally, this D and the one who read first are different. And the one who reads last has taken it from B.
Yes.
And F was not the first or the last to read it.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, then the one who read first could be either C or E.
Yeah.
And one who reads last could be again C or E.
Yeah.
Fine. Now, and there are two readers between B and C.
Yeah.
There are two readers between B and C.
Yeah.
F is not there. Now, between B and C, who would come? D and E would come. So, if you organize this information, logically, if you organize, you will get that from whom did C get the, C pass the newspaper to whom? Actually, C is the first person to read the newspaper. If you look at it logically, C has is the first one to read and who gave it to D.
Okay.
And the one who read the newspaper last. Now, C did not read it. Neither D read it nor F read it. Now, who could it be? The one who reads last has taken from B. So, B is also out of question. So, the last would be E only. Okay. So, this is more of like, you know, using logic. A little ye nahi ho sakta, wo nahi ho sakta, going on that method. A little trial and error has been used.
And which is the answer to the first part? C passed the newspaper to
D.
To whom? To B.
D.
Yeah.
D. Donkey.
Donkey. D.
Okay. D.
Okay. So it is the one who reads first gives it to D.
Yeah. Right.
One minute, I think there is some problem. Okay, we are done with this. We come to this one. Direction sense. One minute before going to this question, I would like you to see the idea. Be clear with the direction chart. Whenever you know it is a question based on direction, just quickly draw your directions. And if you feel that in the direction northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast is not there, no need of drawing that. Just draw north, south, west, east. Remember this direction chart or remember the map of India to remember the direction chart. Fine? Yes? Now always in your direction chart, don't draw it this way. Just draw two lines. Up top is north, bottom is south. The left Gujarat side is west and northeast, eastern side, Manipur, Meghalaya is east. Okay? Now whenever you do not know a starting point, start from the center. You all know when two points intersect, we call it zero. So always start from that zero when you do not know the starting point. Okay? And as told in the information, move along the direction. At times, measurements are given. So write those measurements when you're moving along the direction. So remember this. So first thing, draw the chart, mark your starting point, move along the direction, left, north, jao, ye jao, wo jao. And imagine that you are walking on that direction map. Okay, fine. Now with this idea, solve the 32nd one. Draw your direction chart map. Assume that you are at the center. And then start walking north. Then your right, turn your right. Then right again. And go left. In which direction are you now? What is the answer?
Ma'am, is it east?
Ma'am, is it east?
Yes, it is east. Got it right? Yes, it is east. It is east. All of you got it? Very easy it is. There's not much in that. Now, The 33rd question has directions along with measurements. So when you're drawing, write the measures there in the 33rd question.
And B10. 8 meters.
1 minute.
Huh? Eight meters.
8 meters.
What is the answer?
8 meters.
The answer is 10 meters. Now you must be aware in 7th standard you have used Pythagoras theorem. You know Pythagoras theorem.
Yes,
take
ma'am.
A right angle. One side is 6, not the hypotenuse, but the perpendicular sides. One side is 6, the other side is 8. What is the hypotenuse? It is 10. So based on that, 10 is the answer. I don't see any logic. How did you get 8? Because there is no scope of getting 8. Because if you draw the position where he has reached and the place from where he started is like a diagonal. It is going like diagonally it is going. So it's like a hypotenuse of a right angle triangle. You should have knowledge of hypotenuse Pythagoras theorem when you're solving those questions. Okay, please try. Your answer is 10 meters. Please mute yourself. Got it, all of you? 33rd? Did you all get?
Yes.
Okay, so yes, there is a little logic there. You have to use Pythagoras theorem. Okay. Some more sums on direction sense. Yeah, 34th.
Is it H?
No, it is not H. Look at it carefully. Read it carefully.
Is it D?
It is?
D.
D. D is the correct answer. D,
yeah, faces. It has to be either H or D.
How? It is, yes, ma'am, A faces west and H is a partner of A. So how will it be H? It will be D only. Fine, everyone got it?
Ma'am, in this partners in the sense, do we have to place them opposite or just side by side?
Side by side. These partners partner means so
that's the question. Yeah, but generally when we play those playing cards game, it is always the opposite partner.
Opposite so things, yeah.
I got it.
I placed it opposite. So what will be the answer then?
A and H are partners. Okay, 1 minute.
A is facing westwards.
1 minute. A is this side. A is this side.
Faces north.
Then it is H. You are right then. A and H are partners. And when we are playing cards, opposite people are the partners. Adjacents are not the partners. Opposites are the partners. You are right there. The answer is H, not B.
Ma'am, and just there's one trivia here. Faces towards west.
That means, your face is, you're looking at west.
Yeah, so then that means you are, your position is east.
Yes.
Because your position is east, you are facing towards west, right?
Yeah. Do the 35th one.
Ma'am, is it west?
Ma'am, west.
Just a minute. I'll also, I was not solving, I'll solve it quickly. Okay. Yeah, it is west. West is the correct answer. It's a very simple one.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So, ma'am, miss, for the 34th. For the 34th, H is the answer, right? Because H, A and the, H are partners.
Partners. Whenever you play any game, playing cards carom and all, opposite person is the partner.
A partner.
I was a little confused there.
Ma'am, in this 35th question, so does this half kilometer actually, do we have
just to
really
confuse,
take that into account?
It is just to confuse, right? Yeah. Sometimes it is too confused, but you may take it into account, but it does not really matter. You realize that later. Fine. Should I move ahead?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Clock and calendar. Now, certain things you have to remember about clock and calendar. You know, when you look at a clock, in a day, you know, there are 24 hours. And in a day, how many times the two hands of a clock coincide with each other? So every 1 hour, it will be once. Every 1 hour, it will be once. Now, how many times in 24 hours?
11.
22.
24. Hours. How did you get 24? Think about it. Huh?
Ma'am, because just like we do in maths, cross multiplication, so in 1 hour it is once, so in 24 hours it's going to be 24 into 1, that's 24.
This is not, whenever you get a quick simple answer like this, that means something is going wrong. In a clock, 24 hours, 12 o'clock, it coincides at 12 o'clock and two hands of a, how many times in a day the two hands of a clock coincide? So think of that also.
11.
22.
24 hours. So it won't be 11. 24 hours in 1 hour, in 1 day.
Twice, so 22.
22.
How many times in a day the two hands of a clock coincide?
22.
How did you get 22? Why not 24? Why 22? One thing is sure, when you start your time, let's say you start at night 12 o'clock, midnight 12 o'clock, the time starts. So the first time it coincides, 12 o'clock it coincides, both the hands are at 12. Okay, from there it starts. So you're not supposed to consider the coincidence. after one complete hour, after 1 o'clock, it coincides the first time. Similarly, after 2 o'clock, it coincides the second time. Like that, you keep on adding all that. So two times you do not consider the coincidence of the two hands. That is at the beginning, at the end of 24. So because of that, your number comes 22. To 22.
Yeah.
Yes, clock and calendar questions yes, are ma'am. A little tricky. Just think about it when you're answering. Okay, one calendar sum. If the first day of the month, whenever you're doing a calendar sum, whenever you're doing a calendar sum, draw a calendar quickly like this. And you need not fill in all the details of the calendar. Just write if Sunday is 1, Saturday becomes 7. Because you know 1 to 7, 7 days in a one week. 1 to 7, 7 multiples of 7. 7 next Saturday would be 14, 21, 28. So you quickly do this. And what answer do you get?
Tuesday.
Tuesday is the correct answer. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Tuesday.
See, in clock and calendar, there are many types of questions. You know, some which are very complicated, which are based on mathematics and all. Usually in B.Ed. CET, they do not ask you those type of questions. It is a little simple because they know all of you are not maths people. It is based on simple logic. Okay, look at this clock. The face of a dial is a circle. And the circumference of the clock is divided into 60 equal parts. And every equal part is called a minute space. Okay, every equal part is called a minute space. The clock has two hands. Short one is called the hour or the short hand. Larger one, the minute or the long hand. And in every hour, both hands coincide once. If the hands are in the same straight line, either coinciding or in opposite direction. Okay, like 2:45, that means the hands are in opposite direction. Then they are said to be in a same or 3:15, the hands of the clock are in the same straight line. Two angles are at right angles when they are apart by 15 minutes, like 3 o'clock, 3:30, 3:45. Okay, like that. Or it could be any time in between also. Okay, so that would be, it should be making a perfect angle of 90 degree to get 50, are at right angles means they are apart by 90 degree. And when they are in the opposite direction, they are 30 minutes apart. Just a few quick tips. So hand coincides 11 times in 12 hours. Common position is 12. So common position is not considered. Hence 22 hours. We have seen that. And 1 minute space is 360 degree divided by 60. That means it is 1 minute space is equal to 60 degrees. Actually, then I have never seen any questions so much on mathematics and all in clock and calendar. It is very simple questions. Calendar, whenever calendar questions are asked, you're supposed to draw a quick calendar like this. Odd number of days, you can understand if there are 31 days. So that means there would be 4 complete weeks and 3 odd days. Whenever it is a leap year, it is divisible by 4. That year is divisible by 4. And it has 366 days. Ordinary year, it is not a leap year. The number of days is 365. Remember this
basically. Ma'am, a question.
Yeah.
Ma'am, sometimes they give like a year like 1969 or something like that, and they make us calculate a specific day or something.
Yeah, yeah.
So it is difficult to calculate whether that year was a leap year or not. So how do we make a guess or what?
No, it's easy to calculate. Just if you know 2010, that is divisible by 4, then it is a leap year. Huh.
No.
It should be divisible by 4. Then you come to know whether it is leap year or not.
Okay,
and
ma'am.
And you have to consider complete weeks. Okay?
Ma'am, this sample which you have given,
mm-hmm.
That is for, is like we have to consider this as a January month of any of the year, of the normal year?
It depends. You cannot say that always a January year, because 31 days are there in Jan also, they are there in May also, August also, July also. So you should remember that. January, remember we put use our fingers, we start this, 31 days, February in the groove. March again 31 days, April again 30 days, May again 31 days, June it goes that way, July again go year. So 31, August also comes year, again September 30 days. So remember that aspect.
So then this is supposed to be an ordinary year. It's a month, a 31st month, your 31st day, 31 days year, month of an ordinary year.
Ordinary year. That has nothing to do with. That's just a format I have shown you if you get that type of a question. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
When you are solving those type of sums there, that includes mathematics. You have to calculate the complete weeks and all and then go about. Then you get that particular day. Okay? I'm a little this about whether those type of, but you do try out solving those sums also, solving those type of questions also. Okay, look at this. How many times?
Miss, can you just? Can you just repeat? You said 2010 is divisible by 4.
I did not.
We have to check.
Divisible. You check.
Yeah, it is not divisible.
So it is not a leap year, no? Then. 2012 is a leap year. 2008 was a leap year. Leap year occurs after every...
Okay.
So it should be divisible by 4. There is a question. Okay. Look at the 39th question. Since you are talking about leap year, look at the 39th question. Which year is not a leap year? You can just look and tell me.
700.
B.
Not divisible by 4? Perfect.
Yes.
800 is divisible, 1200 is divisible. So you just have to divide it by 4 and check. If it is completely divisible, it's a leap year. Otherwise, it is not a leap year. Look at the 38th question. How many times in a day the hands of a clock will be at right angle? How many times in a day? How many times in an hour, by the way?
Four, na?
Two times.
Four in a hour. Right angles.
Ma'am, is it 48?
No, it is not 48. Yes, like how you did 24 for coinciding.
44.
Similarly, it covers two and you have to not take the time it repeats. So your answer comes to 22. Similarly, here it is 48, double. So you have to reduce it by four numbers. Four times you have to reduce.
Yeah,
the answer
yeah.
is 44.
444, yes, ma'am.
Look at the 40th question. Either email 10 o'clock question. If you want, you can quickly draw and see.
Ma'am, is it 420?
One minute, I think, I hope my there's no error in my answers. Just check. Let's see, what is it? One minute, I'll also check.
Ma'am, I think it should be 435.
No, one minute. It should not be 435. No. Instead of 425, it should be 440. Now check and tell me. Instead of A, just make the correction. A would be 440.
Yeah, it's 440.
Answer would be 440?
Yeah, ma'am.
It will be 440. There is a small slight typo.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
440. Okay, it is 440. The answer is 440. 820 and the mirror image is exactly the opposite with a lateral inversion. Whenever you have questions on mirror image, you stand in front of a mirror, you'll exactly see the same angles, but only left side becomes right and right side becomes left. So keeping that in mind, you know, at the time is 4:40. Fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine, there's a typing error. It should be 4:40, not 4:25, 4:40. Fine? And I think with this, I come to the end. Yeah, I come to the end of this session. Anything that you'll have to practice. See, however, I may tell you a lot of techniques. Use these techniques and practice solving the same type of questions, like only analogy questions, only calendar questions, only coding decoding questions. It will help you. And if you practice it this way, there are full chances of getting maximum score in mental ability, which is of 40 marks. Teacher aptitude also, I've covered a lot of aspects. You must be reading about it also. So teacher aptitude and mental ability, if you try and get very good score, general knowledge, I can understand. Nobody can get 30 on 30. It's a little difficult. You can get 20, 15 or 20 also, it's fine. So now look at your score. Mental ability, if you end up getting 30, 10 questions go wrong. Teacher aptitude also, if you end up getting 25. 30 plus 25 becomes 55. And plus another 55 plus another 15 or so. So you are getting a good 70 score out of 100. That's a good score. Plus your ELCT marks will be added. So ELCT, there are chances that you end up getting 35 or so. So your score easily goes to 105, which is a good score. Okay. So please practice your mental ability questions. Teacher aptitude also, a lot of things have been discussed. And do read up also. General knowledge also, you can read up a lot of information. We have discussed that also. So you can get a good score. ELCT, please practice. Please practice your ELCT questions also. It is very basic English grammar, synonyms, homonyms, antonyms, and comprehension 20% weightage, which you can get full if you practice. Okay, so try doing it. And I'm sure there is a good score for getting above 100 score. Okay. So with this, I stop here. Whatever questions you could not solve quickly, please practice. You can manage. You can get a good score if you practice using the technique. Okay? Fine? So
ma'am, a question actually.
Yeah?
Ma'am, just like you told synonyms and antonyms and also, there are some words which we might be not aware of if they ask us a synonym or antonym.
Yeah.
So... what are we supposed to do?
See, if you have even an average person, a person who knows English, acha aata hai English. Okay? Most of the people in Mumbai, though we may be from vernacular medium, but we are very clear with our grammar and meaning of words. So in this ELCT paper, the paper is not very difficult. It is a very easy paper as compared to your CET paper. ELCT paper is quite a simple paper. Okay. And let's say 20 out of that 50 marks, 20 marks are only for comprehension, which is so easy that you stand full chance of getting 20 on 20 in comprehension. And other grammar and the basic, you know, questions, other things, aspects. You can easily, getting 35 to 40 marks is very easy in ELCT. I have found students have come to me, BCom students and all have scored 44 in English out of 50. So ELCT is not a big concern. Yes, but do practice questions based on comprehension. Ensure that because now you may not be having the habit of doing comprehension questions. So please do questions, poem comprehension, prose comprehension, dialogue comprehension, picture comprehension. Very simple, but please practice. Okay. Second thing, basic grammar you should be aware of. Positive, negative sentence, parts of speech, figures of speech, question tag, adding a question tag, verbs. These are the basic things you should be clear about. And some idioms, regular ones, idioms and phrases you should be clear of. figures of speech are the regular figures of speech, not the ones like onomatopoeia, mia, and all that. Simple. Simile, metaphor. What is the difference between simile and metaphor? Don't read the theory. Try solving grammar questions so that you understand the difference between what is a simile and metaphor. Personification, climax, anticlimax. These are the basic ones that are asked in the ELCT paper. That's it. 8th standard level grammar is asked in ELCT paper. Is anybody interested in doing an online course in English? Nah, but this is for already students of teacher education colleges. There is a webinar going on
English grammar. Yeah, actually, I had asked about it. Yeah, I had asked about it.
The St. Xavier's one?
No. I'm Shreya. I had asked about it on the group.
But you won't be allowed. No. You won't be allowed for that webinar. You should be a student of teacher education college. Then you should be a student of B.Ed. college. Then only those students are allowed. Right now also, I've put across a Sophia College's communication skill. Somebody had asked. So please, you can...
Yeah, ma'am. But I don't know. For some reason, they have shut their registrations when I went. So I have contacted them for the same.
So just see. Because sometimes the... number is full. There are only 100 students. Sometimes, usually, they allow a capacity of more than 100.
Okay. Yeah, ma'am.
Even the University of Mumbai has one communication skills course. You can do that also. And whenever we come across any such session, we will put it across to you. Okay.
Sure, ma'am.
Fine. Should I stop? Should I stop the meeting now? Any more queries?
No, ma'am.
Fine. Okay. So, see you all.
No, ma'am.
Hope I don't think now I'll conduct any more sessions. This was the 6th I had conducted. I'll try putting those 2 videos on the YouTube and giving you the link. Okay? Just give me some time.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.